What's up, guys? Another late film review. I know I'm a piece of shit, but by this point, you probably expect most of these reviews to be late. I promise that all of the ones that I have, the most recent ones I have, I will get them done. I'll try to get them done before Tuesday. Let's just jump straight into it. The film I will be reviewing this evening is Overlord. This one opens with an introduction to our GIs as they are about to parachute into Nazi-occupied France. It's quite a cool cast for this one. There's Russell Wyatt, who I came to know from his fabulous episode of Black Mirror. He's just such a talented actor, and he really captures my attention any time he's on the screen. I'm interested to see more from him, definitely. There's also a newcomer. I'm definitely going to pronounce these next few names completely wrong, so please bear with me. There's also a newcomer, Jovan Adepo. Jovan Adepo, I don't know, who plays our green main protagonist. There's Pilu as Bayek, as Beek, I'm sorry, I'm butchering these names, who plays our terrifying Nazi commander. And last but not least, there's the beautiful Mathilde Olivia, I'm sorry, who plays a badass sister who looks pretty hot with a flamethrower. See what I did there. Even though the cast aren't really that well known, they really all do a terrific job carrying the film. The story is kind of like if Wolfenstein and Call of Duty Zombies had a baby. It's just utter insanity. Straight from the start of the film, we are brought into this world of chaos with the GI's plane being shot down within the first 10 minutes of the film. The pace does dip a little towards the middle, but our actors do keep it going steadily enough. There isn't really much in terms of action. It's more story building within the first two acts of the film. We do get explosions and Nazis getting shot in the final act. The action doesn't disappoint when there is action. I just wish there was more of it. The action, although, does manage to capture the absolute horror that is war, just with zombies sprinkled on top. I also have to mention the makeup and prosthetics. Each zombie/super soldier looked absolutely horrifying, whether it's bones sticking out of a dude's skin or our German commander missing half of his jaw. You know, just kudos to the team behind this. They really added a touch more reality with their scary designs. I also have to talk about the sound mixing and dubbing. The film is so loud, that you feel every bullet as it hits a wall or a body. So loud that you really feel it in your bones when there's an explosion. So loud that you feel very uncomfortable at every screech, you know, from the zombie super soldiers. The sound design just made for a more disconcerting experience, which I just really appreciated. And my only issue with this film was really the lack of laughs. There were really none whatsoever, which was a bit of a shame. And the main lesson I took from this film was that I really need to research films more extensively before watching them, because I'm going to be seeing faceless Nazi zombies in my dreams for a long, long time. So there we have it, guys. There is my review for Overlord. Let's just jump into the two most important questions. Question number one, would I recommend this film? I personally would probably recommend other films over this film. You know, if you just want to go in and sit down with a tub of popcorn and watch, Nazi soldiers get maimed, you know, and brutalized, you know, and you just want to see a lot of gore, this is definitely the film for you. But I would definitely recommend other films over this one. Watch other films over this one. So I probably wouldn't recommend it, unfortunately. Question number two: does this film belong in the vault? And I'd have to say, probably not. I mean, the film itself kind of reached a certain kind of level that it just plateaued, and that was the general energy of the film throughout until the end. And it was, for lack of a better word, kind of boring, because it did just stay at that one kind of level, which is a shame. So no, this film will not be going into the vault. And there is that little turd-shaped star. It's gone off to wherever it goes, followed by a zombie screech. So there we have it, guys. There's my review for Overlord. If you've seen the film and you liked it, let me know why down in the comments below. If you didn't like it, again, let me know why down in the comments below. And if you like what I'm doing here, guys, please don't forget to like, subscribe, share this video with your friends, family, pets, grandparents, you know, everyone, and keep on supporting me. Until the next one, peace and love, my dudes.